Are these the future of COVID-19 vaccines? Injection-based COVID-19 vaccines have been effective in preventing more hospitalizations and deaths worldwide. But there is more room for improvement, like reducing side effects and increasing efficacy. So, many research groups are evaluating other delivery methods, including through the nose and mouth. Unlike injectables, inhalable vaccines are designed to target the mucosa of the nose and throat. This is to induce an immune response in these areas where SARS-CoV-2 would first enter the body. One of the leading companies in this endeavor is CanSino Biologics. The company has published the interim results of its inhalable vaccine in the Lancet Infectious Diseases. This aerosol version of the Ad5-nCoV vaccine is in the early-stage clinical trial. So far, it is approved for one dose as an injection in China, Pakistan, and Mexico. The inhalable version is found without serious side effects and could induce an immune response. According to the South China Morning Post, the aerosol version is given once several days after the first vaccine dose. Each inhalable dose is just one-fifth of the injectable version. However, it could deliver the same levels of neutralizing antibodies as the single injection. This is promising for those who dislike injections and research in nasal sprays. Besides efficacy, convenience and fewer side effects are the expected edge of these vaccine type. In the trial, 130 Chinese participants were administered a single dose of the injectable version. Then, they were given the inhalable dose 28 days later. Obviously, the trial aimed to see how effective the inhalable version is in triggering an immune response. The design also tested how a different delivery route might limit side effects. So what are the benefits of inhalable vaccines? First, no need for specialized storage. Second, no need for special training to administer. Third, they can be used through disposable devices. Fourth, great appeal for those scared of needles. Fifth, good scalability, as inhalables need smaller doses than injectables. But what about the downsides? While immune responses are observed, some challenges remain. Side effects could not be ruled out yet, despite the lack of serious adverse events. No one knows if the immune response would be treated with potential damage to the airways. This damage might occur due to a reaction to the vaccine or the induced immune response inside the organs. Thus, researchers haven't stopped in evaluating the next generation of COVID vaccines.
Thank you.